Sounds like that. So bebop was the term, name that was given this music, although everybody played a little bit different.
I guess if you want to call it bebop, then it was bebop, but I just found it very, very moving music and very uplifting music.
Just a natural evolution of culture.
Dizzy, Bird, Kenny Clark, each one was tremendously individualistic. Monk brought these harmonic and rhythmic displacement, where you would expect to hear rhythm going one way, he'd kind of moved it around a little bit. And you hear that in Charlie Parker. Charlie Parker goes over the bar line. You hear that in Dizzy Gillespie with some of his long lines.
Charlie Parker had a new approach to playing music. We had the music, but we didn't have the, so to say, pyrotechnics.
See, because Bird could be technical if he wanted to be technical. You know what I mean? But he still swung. He never did quit swinging.
His solos with him, man, were so different. And his way of, sometimes he would go out of the key, come back. He'd overlap into another bar, extend things. That's the first time anything like that had happened that I heard of.
From here I am the first time. I said to myself, that's the way our music should be played.
Saw peanuts.
Jazz musicians were largely self-taught, but the slurred note or earthy vibrato that would have raised a music professor's dander was just what the cabaret crowd ordered. Jazz set the whole body in motion, and its appeal was not restricted to New Orleans. The music began to spread.